we are back again. This is Dr. Chukwudi Ezeobele and Dr. Ozo. Jeff, today we are going to be talking about something that many of us are used to in the Christendom. Well, I'm talking about why do you get sick? Many times, many of us have not been able to answer this question. Why do we get sick? Christians, why do we get sick? Believers, why do we get sick? Just as a human being, why do you get sick? That mystery will be decoded now. And I want you to just get ready, and you are going to hear what the man of God will talk about and how you can get yourself out of it. Dr. Ozo, please, can you share a light on how, why do people get sick?
Well, we get sick for or because of three reasons. One is because we don't have the adequate nutrients or intake or the building blocks of vibrant, healthy cells. Secondly, too much toxins in our food, in our water, in our drug, and generally in our intakes. And thirdly, we get sick because of stress or distress or because of problem or situation and circumstances surrounding us. It could be physical, it could be financial, it could be emotional, marital, job related, and otherwise. And the body reacts to stress the same way by trying to, you know, foster some coping mechanism. Sometimes the body can fail. And that's how sickness can result. And as a matter of fact, these three factors can actually combine and conspire to make us sick.
That's a very great analogy of why we get sick. I'm going to talk about it on the spiritual aspect also, because sometimes sickness can be spiritual.
Yes, in other words, it can be financial sickness.
Yes, and sometimes when we go out of line with the divinity, we get sick physically. Jesus talked about it in 3 John verse 2. He said, I wish above all things that thou may prosper, be in health.
Even as
your soul prospereth. So why is that health part so important to God? Because health is wealth.
Yes.
If you are not healthy, a lot of things that you will want to do in life, you might not be able to do it. You know, things that you say you will do, things that you want to do, sometimes in life, you cannot be able to achieve them if you don't have health. That's why health is necessary to life.
Yes.
Because a healthy man is a wealthy man. Mm-hmm. It's only someone that have health can be able to talk about what they will do tomorrow or what they have done in the past. So, I wish above all things that thou may be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. God wants you to prosper financially, health-wise, and spiritually. So we are going to bring them all together now. Why do you get sick? And in another place in the Bible talks in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. It says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, you see, and I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. Healing is very important to your body. So as it is important to your ground, because if your ground is not healthy, I don't care what you plant there,
very true,
you will not make anything. So I want to share more light on the, as a doctor, how can we prevent sickness in the body? Since we have known why do we get sick because of all these factors, how can we prevent sickness?
Well, we know, and we always say this, that an answer of prevention is better than a pound of cure. In other words, prevention is better or far better than cure. Now we start to do that by watching what we eat.
Okay.
Most of the food we eat today are genetically modified. They are chemicalized food. And the body was not designed to run on chemicals. The body was not even designed to run on drugs, what we call man-made or synthetic drugs or pharmaceuticals. They are chemicals. Now, sometimes we think is the solution actually adds to the problem because they are toxic to the body. You know, we talked about toxins and detoxification.
Yes.
Well, This is where they all come together.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, if you are not eating the right food, or if you are eating processed food,
yes,
chemicalized food, genetically modified food,
mm-hmm,
and also food that has been, you know, polluted by hormones,
yes,
antibiotics,
mm-hmm,
toxins, or even grown in polluted land, the same problem resolves. So not only that, stress also will cause problems. So stress management, of course, you know, we cannot eliminate stress.
No, you can't.
But we can only manage it, stress,
yes,
or control stress. And because we need some degree of stress actually to get up to the bed, from the bed in the morning,
mm-hmm,
so that we can carry out our morning duties, or carry out our vision or dream or goal or work for the day.
Yes.
So now, the first thing we have to do when we want to cure ourselves or prevent disease from happening in the first place is to watch our food. And then I'll give you an example. The body was designed to run on living whole food,
mm,
not fragmented food,
okay,
not polluted food,
yes,
not chemicalized food,
mm-hmm,
not modified food in any way, shape or form. Now, what do we mean by that? You know, we now talk about organic and stuff. By the way, before an average fruit or vegetable hits your shelf,
yes,
or the marketplace, they've been polluted or chemicalized up to 5 times,
yes,
from cultivation,
mm-hmm,
to harvest, and where you buy your produce in our normal or regular supermarket.
Yes.
Now, let me give you an example. We cannot live on drugs. Nobody lives on pills.
Yes.
Even if the food is not organic, we still need our food, first of all, because the greatest medicine is food.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the only problem is that most of us don't eat raw food. And we have to also stop the thinking that if food is not sweet, that is not good. Don't eat for appetite.
Yes.
Eat for health. We have to change that mentality. And therefore, food that we think do not taste good are actually good for our body.
Yes.
And I'll give you some example. Things like cucumber, strawberries,
mm-hmm,
food like your sweet potato is excellent.
Yes.
Things like superfood like oat. And then I'm not talking about processed food, because when you talk about processed food, they also add to the toxic burden to the body.
Yes.
By processed food, I mean your white rice, white pasta,
mm-hmm,
your bread, anything made with flour, you know, processed flour, they are devitalized food. They,
yes,
they are empty calories,
mm-hmm,
including pounded yam, because you see, anything you put in the shelf, you have to put chemical or toxins or preservatives,
yes,
to keep them, otherwise they're rotten and then smell and then cause transitivity. So the key actually is to eat living, whole, unfragmented, unchemicalized, unpasteurized food. Don't modify the food.
Yes.
No man is more intelligent than God. Eat food the way it is created. That's why people prefer organic. However, if you still don't find organic, it's the way. And the thing again, apart from food, is our water.
Mm.
See, when people are thirsty today, what do? They reach out for a soda.
Yes.
Reach out for what I call colored sugar water.
Some even go
including
to,
energy drinks.
Go to the level of taking alcohol. I went to Europe sometime in Germany. I discovered that everybody was drinking beer. Beer was like water.
No, they say that their water is not good. Their water is polluted. So their water is actually beer, even little children.
So
alcohol is just the in thing. And that's why the life expectation or life span is very short. Because whenever you take alcohol, you not only pollute the body, you can create toxicity, you create liver disease,
mm-hmm,
or cirrhosis of the liver. And alcohol also kills the brain cells, and the brain controls everything. And we are not just talking about that, but also the psycho-spiritual consequences of alcohol, driving under the influence of alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
Your inhibition is gone. You can beat your wife. You can cause violence. You can do things you cannot do. And start saying things and becoming loquacious. So alcohol, I call it demon in a bottle. And the funny thing is that anything alcohol can do, sugar can do it, because they are from the same family. People can be addicted to sugar, including, you know, high fructose corn syrup is everywhere. And people also have forgotten that sugar is almost virtually in whatever we take. For instance, milk has its sugar. we call it lactose or milk sugar. We have even your malt has maltose or malt sugar. We have the sucrose or the table sugar. We have the fructose or fruit sugar. So fruit sugar literally is everywhere.
Yes.
So, and we have to detoxify ourselves also from sugar. So, and apart from that, another thing we need to do, apart from the, our food and our water, another thing that we need to do is also to make sure we de-stress our body.
De-stress our body. But also, as a Christian, the Bible says in the book of 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, as a new babe, newborn babe, desire the sincere milk of the word.
That you might grow thereby.
The word of God is the basic of Christianity.
That's right.
So a lot of Christians are running about looking for signs and wonders. The Bible says desire this. If you don't hear the word, the Bible says faith comes by hearing. Hearing what?
The word of God.
So as you are eating right in your body, natural foods and other things, make sure you go to a place where you are being fed with
spiritually
with the word that will rejuvenate you, that will change your life. It is only when people hear, that is when they will change. The Bible says that my people cannot do anything unless they hear. So are you an agent that brings the word of God, or you are just there professing the benefit of the kingdom? I mean, let me tell you, most of those benefits that we have heard in the church, heard in the kingdom of God, if you have not been grounded, if you don't understand the principles and the laws that will trigger those blessings and those benefits, you might not get them, even if you are being prophesied to. It took God 25 years to overhaul the brain of Abraham and give him all the things that he has promised him. He gave him the promise the first day he called in Genesis chapter 12, verse 1. But it took 25 years for him to teach him how to make those things happen. So don't just run for the prophecies and run for where you will be entertained. Desire the sincere milk of the word so that your body shall begin to function the way God wants it, as you also eat the right food. Don't change this diet. We are coming back. Dr. Ozo is loaded, very, very loaded with a lot of things. And I'm promising you that as you continue to follow us on Time of Inspiration, your lives will never be the same again. We are bringing both worlds to you. Health and wealth, that is what we are talking about this day. Health and wealth, how it has to do also with the kingdom of God. Have a wonderful day. God bless you.
Número 12.